before the thousands in attendance and the millions watching around the world on DAZN Sky Sports. Ladies and gentlemen, from the Windy City, Chicago, Illinois, let's get ready to rumble!
We lost a lot of talented individuals in the streets of Chicago that could have been president of the United States. They could have been governors, mayors, the biggest entertainers in the industry. Look at the skyline, it's beautiful. You think about how beautiful their talent was.
Each time. I'm people get their kicks stomping on a dream. But I don't let it get me down. Cause this fine old world, it keeps spinning around.
pour out some liquor and I reminisce. I wish I could take your pain away. Tell us it was fair. Thank you.
The idea of dream analysis, I suppose, is one of Freud's, perhaps Freud's major contribution to modern Western thought. The idea was there was something to dreams. And I suppose what Freud did is said, hey, look, isn't it strange? We have this whole other form of thought that we engage in at night, and it speaks in a language that we don't really understand. And so what the hell is that? And you can say, and many modern people do, dreams are of no significance, or even that they're random processes, which is an absurd proposition, obviously, because they're obviously not random. So Freud's idea was that there was something in dreams that was informative.
Thank you. your essential nature is not something. Not content. Not form. The best description through words is to say not what it is not. And then you're left with what it is, which cannot be named, but can be known, but cannot be known conceptually, because every concept is again a name and a form.
Be some stuff you're gonna see that's gonna make it hard to smile in the future.
We'll be right back. wisdom is actually a quintessential cognitive science topic, talking about the brain, and then you have machine learning, talking about types of information processing. You know, is it when the brain is processing information, is it processing it as a computer, as a neural network, as a dynamical system? Talking about the brain. This is a place where philosophers have a really important job, because philosophy has been the long-standing attempt to provide a synoptic integration, to take important concepts and theoretical material and data from these various disciplines and ask, how does it all fit together? What does it all mean for us? And it makes uses of tools of plausibility reasoning and conceptual innovation and insightful integration.
Smile makes me crazy. crazy. Your patience got me anxious. My mama think you ain't good enough. Daddy think you ain't hard enough for me. But they don't know who you are. See you as a boy, you a king in my eyes. Never been afraid, you my man from the start. Life knew we went the straight back in my life. You, I'll do anything you want me to. You, I'll do anything you want me to. To you, I'll do anything you want me to.
Speaking. Who is this? He did what? He remixed what? Why, we'll sue the bastards. Mouthpiece, and from that moment your trouble will cease when they find out
that they're swimming with the sharks, and that you know, they're asked to sign contracts that they don't understand. Sometimes they come to their senses.
Now by and by, and after a while, get it down, get to a trial. We'll sue them federal, we'll sue them state. We'll sue them in a way they can relate. Then we'll do a thing they'll really feel. We'll take them up on appeal. Your honors, permit me to introduce myself.
I'm the rep and
a lawyer from way downtown. People come to me when someone puts them down. For a very reasonable fee, I rap for them. I'll set them free. Free.
I certainly know where the bones are buried relative to the industry, having been involved in it for 50 years. But, you know, sometimes people, I'm an old guy, they might want some guy that they can smoke pot with, you know what I mean?
I met Jay in 2007. I was working at restaurants, washing dishes. I was working at factories. I was doing whatever I can to make an honest living. You know, I was kind of done with the drug dealing or whatever. That gets you in jail. I decided to go into a business class that had to do with music, since that's what I was into. And Jay happened to be one of the instructors one day. He was teaching contracts and publishing and negotiation and seemed like a real interesting guy. So I stayed after class, and we were talking for a while. And he says, hey, you seem like a bright kid, you know? You want to come work with me at the office? I said, you know, why not? Let's give it a shot. Come to find out, he's one of the biggest music attorneys in the industry, telling me stories about hanging out with James Brown, Willie Dixon, Muddy Waters, all these icons that you only hear about on television or radio, or, you know, music history books. It was amazing. It was incredible. It was insane. It was wild. How am I in this situation? All right, let's run with it. So working next to Jay, I'm like running into people like Casper of the Cha-Cha Slide, who was giving me some shout outs and some of my samples. You know, I'm taking rides in Squirrel's Cadillac of the Shinies, and he's telling me what that era was like. And you know, being a househead, now I'm over here saying what's up to Farley Jackmaster Funk and recording more music for Daryl Pandy. Or we're over here hanging out with Gene Chandler, the Duke of Earl, in Greektown. Like, all right, I like some cheese that's on fire. That's cool. They call it Saganaki. Just a ghetto kid from the south side of Chicago. 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 I shouldn't even throw echoes. It's a whole nother song now. From the south side of Chicago. South side of Chicago. South side of Chicago, 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 south side of Chicago. Hold up, hold up. That's it.